Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Allison Cruz, and I'd like to welcome you once again to Fallout 3, where we had just got done revisiting Vault 101 and saving the inhabitants from themselves, for a mutiny had occurred, and, well, we put an end to it by allowing them to open the vault door towards the outside world. And our prize for doing this lovely deed was our dog meat back, our beloved little puppy friend. By God, it's amazing and it's awesome. He's finally back and he's just as much of a maverick as he was before. Look at him. Look at him run. Look at him. Oh, puppy. So I did end up looking up how to get your companions back, and depending on which one you actually want to, you know, get back, they'll respawn in certain areas. So Dogmeat, for example, will return to Vault 101. Unfortunately, by allotting a specific amount of time to pass, we were able to... Jerk. Oh my god. We were able to get him to spawn. So fortunately, that turned out really well for him to spawn like that. Oh, sweet Jesus! No! What are you doing? Another Yao Guoi? We are literally right outside of Vault 101. No. Not acceptable. Not today, sir. Not today, my friend. This is not how things work. So... that just happened. God, being above the level threshold is really good. So... So in this part, I do believe that I would like to continue on through Middle Earth and return to Girdershade so that we can continue, or at least start, that Nuka-Cola Quantum Quest, and, that's gonna be... sweet Jesus, that Enclave bot just got murdered. Just so that we can get that out of the way, as well as not having to go straight to doing Moira's things. Oh, it's a Mr. Gutsy, and he has not taken his protocol initiation. Here, let's do this. Do I need to sneak up on him? Apparently, I can't just turn him off. He's hostile! No surrender. How dare you put my dog on fire, you piece of shite? That is not very acceptable. No. Dog meat, you'll be fine, right? Woof woof. So I just want to discover somewhere before we head back there, because we did discover it, and we also discovered a Deathclaw Deathtrap Lair. So that was also really fun. Well, let's just hope we don't get into any insane random encounters here, because that would be lovely. There's barbed wire and things, also people. Uh-oh, was that a... did you hear that beep? Oh, sweet jeez, it's a giant rat. Oh my god, giant... okay, it's just... just the giant rad scorpion. Thank you for being the distraction there, Doggy. There we go. Didn't make him goo, but it was close enough, you know what I'm saying. Oh, so welcome to October 15th, ladies and gentlemen. You guys are probably going to see this in a few weeks because I'm actually pretty close to being caught up. I just finished the wonderful 101 today, for real, including the, you know, the prologue, so that was actually really nice. I'm quite proud of myself for finishing off, but there will be a continuation, and that won't happen until later. My god, what is down here? We have aerial advantages, so let's put good use to- oh, sweet Jesus! Oh my god, Enclave Hellfire Troopers! Oh jeez, dog meat? Wait, are there two of them? No, there's just the one. Then what's that third thing? Here, let's kill this guy so he has no chance survival. Ooh boy. Oh, what? What? How are you hitting me from there? This is great, guys. This is great. All right, let's try this again. Please. Really? Really? All right, enough with that bullshit. Here, shotgun rain time, please. All right, you guys want to come up here so you can fight the old-fashioned way, huh? Perhaps. Dogmeat, what are you doing? Why are you doing that? No! No fire in the hole! How dare you? How dare you, you son of a bitch! Oh! Yeah! Oh, don't even... my leg! It's okay, Fred. Alright, asshole. You wanna try shooting my dog again? Huh? He doesn't care. Are you sure that's returning fire? Are you okay there? Oh god, he's alive! Okay, I thought he was stuck, so I reloaded. Not gonna make that mistake again, bitch. Oh. Mwah! It's beautiful. God damn, I love that thing. Oh, so we got Electron Charge Packs, as well as a couple of those. Oh man, so this one had Enclave Power Armor. Okay, I thought he was gonna have that thing that we had before, the Hellfire Armor. And then, ooh, a crate. Let's see, what is inside said crate? If I don't fuck it up. There we go, sweet. And, ooh, Plasma Mine. We'll take that, we'll explode some pants later. And this guy was loaded, holy mother of God, and he had Scotch. And then we had that one last guy. God, why are these things set up everywhere? Is it just because we've completed a certain number of quests and things? Oh, and he did have it, and a heavy incinerator. Ooh, baby. That was kind of cool. I guess that's why it was able to get me from so far away. And no, I was not quoting a song by Dragon Force. Alright, so we will repair, and we will repair. Good, good. We taped together a couple of Hellfire armor pieces and was able to make it as strong as ever. Hmm, I'm curious, this heavy incinerator, it uses flamer fuel, but it didn't look like it was like a flamethrower. Ooh, baby! Ooh, I might like that. Might like it a lot. Ooh. Something about flamethrowers and their extremely limited range. Just not a big fan. Not a huge fan. Okay, so now that we're leaving behind these dead corpses, let's see what lies over here in this pile of rubble. This is all I wanted to do. I just wanted to look at a place to discover so that we can come back to it later and explore the hell out of it. Because by God, I would love to explore the hell out of, like, so many of these places. Like, I wouldn't necessarily sleep here, but if I wouldn't explore to hell and back, then I'm just becoming redundant now. Alright, so what do we got here? Fort Independence. This also sounds extremely, extremely disappointing. Ooh, who are those people? They're gonna want me to raid that thing, aren't they? Or wait, maybe it's not that. Maybe that's not Fort Independence. That looks boring as shit. Oh, Jesus.
Raider incoming.
No, 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 no. I am not a raider. Oh, from somewhere else. Okay, I feel like this is some shit that we don't need to be dealing with right now.
Going to get yourself killed out here? You mind doing it further away from our bunker? I don't want your corpse stinking up our little patch of heaven.
Okay. It'd clash with the drapes.
Yeah, the red would never go with all this brown. But if we remodel and still need a corpse, we'll call you. Okay?
Wow.
I'm Defender Anne Marie Morgan with the Outcasts. Good to have someone else out here who can keep up.
Thank you. Who are you people?
We call ourselves the Outcasts, and we collect technology to preserve it from tribals and idiot locals. And before you ask, we were cast out from that company of zeros who call themselves Lion's Brotherhood of Steel.
Okay.
The way we figure it, if traitors think we're too harsh in following orders, we're probably doing something right.
So, interesting. So we've got Outcast, the Brotherhood of Steel, the Enclave. How many factions does this game need? But tell me more about the Outcasts, please.
We collect technology, and most people want what we've collected.
Hmm.
Right now, we're pretty much stuck defending this fort, but that won't be forever.
Interesting.
Once we regroup, we'll continue our work and keep moving back west.
All right, cool. How do I sign up, I guess?
We aren't recruiting, kid. Old Sap Lions might trust walk-ins, but we don't.
Really?
But if you want to help out, well, we might be able to work out a deal.
Uh-huh.
You bring in technological devices, and we'll pay you a finder's fee based on the device. But Protector Kasdan would have to okay it first.
Interesting. All right. Sounds good.
Okay. But first you'll have to talk with Protector Kasdan. You can work out the details with him.
All right. I guess we can take a slight detour. Seriously? You're gonna do that bullshit with me? Is he up here? Or was that just the turret? The turret that murdered things. Also, don't mind this weapon that I just took out from a person who tried to murder me. So wait, that is the fort. What the hell? Where is it? Here, just let me go ahead and open that. Are you Kasdan? Yes, you are.
I'm Protector Henry Kasdan, leader of the Outcasts. This had better be good.
Thank you so much for
Normally,
seeing
I
me.
I wouldn't be wasting my time talking to a local, but Morgan tells me you can make yourself useful. So, interested in collecting technology for us?
I guess so. I'll take it.
That's what I like to hear. You can start immediately.
Excellent.
You'll report directly to me. I'll take in your gear and dole out your pay. Now get cracking.
Okay. What technology?
Let's see what you've got.
Ooh, I can just give him this stuff. Alright, here, take this laser pistol.
We can always use another one of these. How'd you like your payment?
Well, how can I get it? Stimpaks right away, frag grenades. Frag grenades.
Be careful. These can pack quite a pop.
Alright, so this is pretty interesting. Oh, two frag grenades. Oh, that's shitty.
Okay, then.
Alright, well, that was a little disappointing. So I guess we can trade some stuff with them. I've got a bunch of plasma pistols and things back where I live, so we can deal with that there. But for now, let's actually head to where we need to. Also, we've got the raid plans here. In light of increased agitation from the rebels, there we go, midnight raid, jail cell is Stockholm, interesting. And the password to Vault 101 is Amada. Nice. Still very self-indulgent. So we've got four independents there. We'll return there later. But first, let's head to... Wait, where's Girdershade? And we discovered... Yeah, we discovered the Nuka-Cola plant. So, good shade. Thank you. Whew, alright. So, let's go visit Ronald Laren. No relation to Shay. And... Where was... Is this... I don't know if Ron... I think it was a girl, right? Yeah, Sierra Petrovita. Yeah. Let's go see her. I have no idea what use she's going to be to us. Oh, how's it going? Sierra Petrovita.
Sierra Petrovita's the name. Good to see a new face in Girdershade.
Petrovita.
I take it you're here to check out my Nuka-Cola collection and take the tour.
I guess so. But your Nuka-Cola collection? Wow.
I have one of the... No. The best Nuka-Cola collection in the Capital Wasteland.
Whoa!
Heck, I've won the Nuka-Cola Fan Club Collection Award for the last 10 years in a row.
All right, that's a little embarrassing.
Yep, I'm the president, the recording secretary, and the treasurer.
Oh.
Once a year, we gather here in Girdershade to have a cook-off using Nuka-Cola and the recipe.
Interesting.
Last year, I won with my poached roach and Nuka sauce. Ugh. Delicious.
How many members are in your club?
Well, only two right now, me and Ronald. But membership is open to the public. You can join if you like.
Perhaps I do. But who's Ronald?
Ronald? Oh, I'm sorry. I figured you met him already. He usually chats with people who enter Girdershade. He's my neighbor and my protector, as he calls it. Imagine if some nasty raider wanted to take my stuff. He'd show them a thing or two.
Interesting.
He's such a sweetie. You should talk to him.
I have a feeling he probably is the complete opposite of what she's saying. Yeah, he sounds great. So, oh yeah, tour.
I sure did. Want to take it now?
I guess so.
How can you resist? This stuff is so cool.
I guess so. I think I'd rather be smacked in the head with a blunt instrument. That would be rude.
Well, come on then. Let me show you around. But no free Nuka-Cola until the end of the tour.
Alright, we'll take it. What do you got for me, sister? We've got ourselves the Nuka-Cola challenge.
When Nuka-Cola was invented by John Caleb Braverton in 2044, it quickly became the world's most popular soft drink.
Interesting. Thank you. Ooh, this looks cool. Oh, there's a Nuka-Cola truck.
Wonder Drink soon drew a dedicated following, which prompted the Nuka-Cola Corporation to release many promotional items like these.
I'm right here. Why are you turned around like that? Ooh, and there's a Nuka-Cola stool. I will sit here, and I will enjoy life. It's beautiful. Ugh, there we go.
By 2067, a Nuka-Cola machine such as this rare, pristine model could be found on almost every street in America.
That looks so sad. Look at me, I'm so sad. Aww.
Even in today's crazy world, Nuka-Cola is still the number one choice of refreshment among Armageddon survivors.
Nice.
As promised, here's a little pick-me-up. An ice-cold Nuka-Cola. Just look at the frost on the bottle.
Ooh.
So cold.
Actually,
and delicious. Pardon me. I tend to lose myself when I hold on to a Nuka-Cola. Before I get to the little proposition I have for you, let me tell you a little bit about Nuka-Cola Quantum.
Oh, hey. Well, she just, like, explained 29 million things, and I was just gonna say, oh yeah, so the ice-cold Nuka-Cola, I think, is actually the best kind of Nuka-Cola you can drink. And one of your houses that you can have themed could include a refrigerator where you could put all your Nuka-Colas in and get, like, a bunch of ice-cold ones if you want, so that's kinda cool. Anyway, Quantum, never heard of it before. Please explain what this is, Miss Petrovita.
Well, right before the bombs fell, the good folks at Nuka-Cola developed what they hoped was an improvement on the original formula. Calling it Nuka-Cola Quantum. It was said to have twice the calories, twice the carbohydrates, twice the caffeine, and twice the taste.
Hey, so, that's a catch line if I ever heard it myself.
Well, the flavor certainly wasn't the issue. The public was just split on the unique feature of the Quantum's appearance. You see, to make it stand out on store shelves and to give it that extra kick, the formula called for a mild isotope. The effect was a drink that not only boosted your energy, but also glowed with a bright blue light.
Interesting. So it's, radioactive, you say?
Oh no, only ever so mildly. No ill effects were ever recorded. Well, it does have the unique property of making your, your pee glow.
Interesting. So, is that really what you're into? Is the glow piss?
I love the stuff! I can't get enough of it! I thought I was hooked on regular Nuka-Cola, but the Quantum beats it by a long shot.
Wow.
I've got to have more!
Jesus Christ, okay. tell me what you want already.
Can you resist the taste that'll blow up in your face? Like Ronald always says. He thinks of the best Nuka-Cola jingles. Anyway, for every bottle you bring me, I'll pay you some caps. You know, for expenses. But if you're super cool and find, like, enough bottles to fill my Nuka-Cola machine, 30 in all, I got a super secret cool prize for you.
Oh, nice. No secrets between friends.
Oh, okay.
Ooh.
I have a schematic for the Nuka grenade. The only one in the whole capital wasteland. Bring me the bottles, and it's yours.
Sweet.
Imagine the look on the target's face when they are burning alive in an effervescent explosion of cola and fruit flavors.
Well.
So, what do you say? Will you bring me the bottles?
I guess I don't have a choice. But, yeah, you got a deal.
Oh, goody. I can taste the Quantum already. Good luck to you, sweetie.
I can see this brings a lot of solace to you, Madame Petrovita. So, yeah, is there anything really interesting in Girdershade? Because from what I saw, there are only two houses here.
Well, to the east, there are some nasty raiders in Evergreen Mills. I'd stay away from there if I were you.
All right.
Luckily, we're kind of hidden here under the old highway, so no one bothers us.
I wouldn't really say you were hidden, but all right. So, yeah, do you have a clue where I can start finally looking?
In fact, I do. Surprised you, didn't I?
I guess so.
Your best bet would be to find the ruins of the DC Nuka-Cola bottling facility. Find the shipping manifests inside.
Okay.
With them in hand, you should have a good clue as to where the Quantum was delivered.
That actually makes a lot of sense.
While you're there, you may even be able to find some bottles of Quantum.
That works. That works. But what do you know about it? Help me.
Well, the DC facility was like their main factory just before the bombs fell. All the research they did was performed there. It was the only facility to ever produce Quantum. They were in a test market mode, and they would have expanded production if the drink caught on. Too bad they didn't. Otherwise, Quantum would be as plentiful as regular Nuka-Cola.
That would probably be a bad thing, right? Anyway.
Be careful out there, sweetie.
Thanks. Thanks. You don't look like you're very bright, but I appreciate it. Ooh, Nuka-Colas. Can I just... Stop it! I had them all in alphabetical order. There you go. Just made your room just look a little bit more authentic. Ah. Alright. So let's get out of here, shall we? Back to Girdershade. Girdershade will go. Oh my god.
Hey, pal. What were you doing in Sierra's place?
Screw you, buddy!
Nope. I'm not the marrying type. Look, I'm just trying to make sure no one messes with her. You do the same to protect your woman, too.
Except I don't have a woman. Take a number.
I think you better calm down and think long and hard about that. Girdershade is my town. You can't just walk in here and tell me you're taking Sierra.
Why not?
I'm gonna be the first one to tap into her goods, not you. Born and raised that way, and damn proud of it.
Seriously?
Look, I have an offer to give you. You can either stand there, be a pain in the ass, or you can listen to what I have to say.
I guess. What is it?
I know she's asked you to find her some Nuka-Cola Quantum.
How do you know that?
Like she asks everyone that wanders through here.
Oh.
What I'm proposing is you still look for the drinks, but instead of bringing it to her, you bring it to me.
Ooh.
She'll be so impressed that I got all the Nuka-Cola for her, she'll melt in my arms like butter.
Seriously?
I pay you the same she was going to pay, and everyone's happy.
Seriously? Really? You would actually be such a scumbag as to manipulate her into boning you, good friend. I don't know.
You devious bastard. I didn't figure you were that clever. All right, double it is. Just bring me those bottles. If I have to listen to Sierra ramble on any longer, I think I'll blow my brains out.
Okay, so...
So you gonna do it or what?
Sure. I'm always for making more... I hope this doesn't give me bad karma. I think the act of actually giving them to him first would be bad, just not accepting his offer.
Thought you might. Good. I'll see you soon, then.
Whew. Alright, we're on everybody's good side. By the way, do you have a bed I could sleep in? That would be lovely. Anyway, recover 30 bottles, and we have to go to the shipping plant. Let's take a look at Mr. Laren's home, shall we? I can't imagine there being anything of relative interest here, but I would like to sleep in his bed. I don't know, what do you want? You have nothing here of any interest. Ugh, it's owned. It's owned. And then... What the? Oh, it was a bottle cap. I was like, what the hell was that book? Yep, nothing of any interest here whatsoever. How's it going? Didn't know I'd see you here. I probably should go take a nap somewhere, but I'm sure we could probably find a raider camp nearby. Do that nonsense. So to the Nuka-Cola plant we go. Now, if I'm not mistaken... Ooh, there's somebody actually over there. Or was that dog meat? It was dog meat. The first time we discovered this place, I don't think we ever ended up finding that Nuka-Cola truck, but it might be around the back, and ooh, this guy right here, this guy. Ho ho ho. Here we go. Oh, yes. Sneak attack critical. By God. Alright, and where's that other person? Going to investigate the ruins of your friend, perhaps? It's like, oh my god, his fingers are in my soup! Ooh. Nope. Oh, and there's also a good person in front of me. It's probably an eye- Oh! Dog meat! Dog meat! Why do you give away our element of surprise? Ah, now you just ruined it! There we go. This works. This also works very well in our favor. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, so these are just two lonesome raiders that have absolutely nothing to do with anything, so... I guess we could ignore them for now. Huh. There's no beds over there. And I don't think there are any beds in the Nuka-Cola factory. Oh, wait. There they are. Right there. Let's go grab it. Let's go grab the Nuka-Colas that lie within. Unless we already did. I just don't remember. I think I vaguely recall saying, oh, yeah, we'll come back to it. Maybe there are beds inside of these overturned trucks. Thought ever occur to you that might be the case? Nope, nothing in here. Huh, I was thinking there might be one or two. Ah, haha, hey. Nuka-Cola Quantum. Sweet. It's broad daylight, so if I miss any obvious ones, then, well, I'll apologize. Nothing there. I hope that is the only one. Damn it, that sucks, man. Alright, well, let's head inside the factory where the Quantums were manufactured and hope, you know, we can find a couple here or there. Maybe a nice cardboard bed or two. That would be very lovely as well. Uh-oh, what is over there? Dog meat, please don't go attack it. Please don't go attack it. How do I tell you to heal? To stand down? Is it just a raider? Ooh, it might just be... Oh, it is just a raider. Ah, I'm stuck. This is like the worst, Oh, right here. Just don't let this hit like the top of the thing. Nope. Don't give us away. Oh, really? Seriously? Oh god, there she goes. Can we kill you? There we go. Beautiful. What the hell just went flying towards me? Oh man. Okay, I feel like we should find a bed because there are raiders galore. And I really would just like to find somewhere to sleep for just a couple of minutes. I would be satisfied if that could be the case, but if there's nothing, let's just go inside. I don't even know if there's anything inside of the Nuka-Cola factory. It seems like maybe robots, but at best, probably rad roaches. So we will return. We will return to our hunt for a bed later. Just open the door to factory floor. Because why the hell not? Whew. Oh, and there are enemies, but luckily we have our lovely dog meat here. Also, Nuka-Cola Quantum Shipping Manifest. We have to remember to find that. We've got nothing here. I'm just going to explore the hell out of this place until I find out what enemies are in here. Just want to be a little bit careful. And things will be good. Ooh, a very hard door. Damn it! Damn it, of course I would just barely be missing it. Also, there's a hole in the ceiling here. I was gonna say, could we fall through that? But I don't think we can. Is there... Oh, there's actually a thing in there! What the hell? Okay, what a lovely surprise. Okay, because I was just gonna say, when we were in the Arlington Library, there was a place that we could have gone, that we were upstairs and we fell through the ceiling, so I've just been watching for those just in case. And nice! Okay, what do we have? Securitron, Securitron, will attack on the impact. Blah, 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 blah. Peace out, bitch. Okay, so yeah, Nuka-Cola security. It's good stuff. Good stuff, man. All right, Nuka-Cola's, anything over here? Nothing, nothing. Dean's Electronics. Okay, books for days. Already a better grab than the Fort Bannister romp. Easily. Alright, there's gonna be no Nuka-Cola Quantums in any of the things. Do you think people who work at Pepsi and Coca-Cola actually have vending machines in their offices? It's like, that's a little desperate, right? I mean, you're really grasping for straws there. I mean, you think about it and you're just like, well, maybe they do, maybe they don't. Alright, move, dog meat, please. More security? More security? You don't see me. You don't see me. Uh-oh. No. Right here. Oh, there it is. Oh. God damn it. God, why would you need security bots in a place like this? Like, this is a straight up office area. Why would you need, like, Securitron robots to protect you? Well, let's take a look at this research terminal. Company announcement. Quantum progress report. 67. Have subjects in the Nuka-Cola Quantum program are responding well to the reconfigured taste and new isotope. Okay, so you sampling 50, acceptable number of cases, sweet. What about 55? It's proven to, oh, uh-oh, these are bad ones. just a bunch of weird flavor testing jargon. Disastrous failure? They suffered severe internal organs and died? I shouldn't laugh at that, but these are, oh my god, Nuka condolences. Fruit and cheese packages, oh my god. Do you think Coca-Cola has ever gone through something like this? Because there's always that weird thing that people say, it's like, oh, blah, 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 they used to put actual cocaine in Coca-Cola. It's like, did they really though? I've always just been too lazy to like look that up and confirm, but that just sounds ridiculous. So anyway, and this looks bad. Okay, ooh, that got dark quickly. Oh my god. Bottle cap, thank you. And also a safe that requires a key with a lock that cannot be picked. What are you doing? Stop! Don't do that! Look at that janky ass laser coming from his face. Don't you even think about it. Don't you even compute about it. Ooh, yeah! Oh, beautiful. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful, and yeah, dog meat! Dog meat is the man. And I really hope that thing does not explode in my face. That'd be lovely. Because I know vehicles in this game, they tend to do a number on you. Especially when they're burning and things explode. Is there nothing over here? What a lousy factory floor this is. How inefficient is this? Look at it. It's just a bunch of stupid things here that have nothing to do with anything. I always love that term. It's such a dumb term, nothing to do about anything. It's just redundant, is all. Okay, so this will take us to the trucks, so this would be the loading zone. Huh. But it appears as though there are no ways to do things.
By order of
what the? Oh, sweet Jesus! Nuke-alerts, and also I'm pretty sure that goddamn motorcycle just exploded behind us. Can we try this? Oh, man. Okay, so nuke-alerts are now a thing, also. Yeah, look at this, it's over here. That thing, oh my god, we were so close to death. Oh, but I'm glad we did not perish. Okay, so the nuke-alerts are a thing. Apparently gives us not too bad of stats. Huh. Interesting. So let's open the door to storage and mixing vats, I guess. Vats. Okay, uh-oh. Dog meat, dog meat. No, dog meat. Good boy. This is my happy face. So go away to Vault 101. That's fine. It's fine, we don't need stealth where we're going. I just want to be able to turn off if- Oh, there are no Protectrons down here. Just nuke-alerts. Oh. Oh, come on! Dog meat! Help! Dog meat! Dog meat! There we go. Oh, Jesus. Dog meat. Are you good? Come on. Alright, shotgun rain time. There's gotta be no other. Wow, this thing is like pretty much immune to the hazards and dangers of shotgun rain, and that's all they're carrying is just nuke-alert meat. Nothing of interest in, our Protectron buddy. Can we activate this man? Energy cells, ooh, this is good stuff. Also got a laser pistol, and wait, what the, oh, there's a thing there. Welcome to the Nuka-Cola family. Interesting. Do I really feel like I should be welcomed? Not necessarily, but that's quite alright. We got some ammo here. Okay. I'm gonna read that real fast. Hold on. I want to take a look at that. Notes. Okay. Hello, Larry. On behalf of the Nuka-Cola Corporation, I'd like to welcome you to the shipping department. Your official job posting a shipping clerk and my employee ID. Thanks. Well, okay, whatever. I don't care. Anyway, automated maintenance. This should be quite simple romp. There's nothing on this side. Literally nothing. Who cares? Damn it, that's not one. Would it be, it wouldn't be party. It's actually world. See? By process of elimination, you can see that I deduced the letters and the words. Oh, let's run the maintenance routine. Oh, man. See, I cracked myself up. Today was an extremely long day at work. And I was just in a mood to just be like, hey, everybody, fuck yourselves. What are you talking about? Do I need to kill you?
Running default factory protocol.
Do I need to straight up murder you?
Loading daily agenda. Error.
Oh, I can deactivate him. I wanted to explode his pants with a pulse grenade. Oh, shit. Are you going to be my friend? Or are we going to have an issue here, Mr. Excalibur? I feel like we're going to have a bit of an issue here. I feel a little uncomfortable letting you roam free, so I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I am so sorry. Oh, and that was my shotgun. God damn it. You did not deserve a death so noble and heroic as to have been felled by shotgun rain, but I guess, whoops, I accidentally smacked my controller. And that, like, activated the R trigger. Whoops. See, I have a weird tendency to do this thing with hand jives. It's pretty frequent that I- What the- That was not okay! Did you see that? He just spawned out of nowhere. God damn it. Help! Dog meat! Dog meat! There we go. Alright, things are starting to look great here. Alright, so we're gonna constantly be under the threat of radiation, but that's alright. What the hell? These things. He goes, oh god, let's try this. Let's try this. Plan B! Plan B! Here, taste this alien technology, assholes! God, this auto-aiming bullshit. Oh, man. Well, good stuff. Good stuff, you guys. That was wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. Whew. Okay, so we're not being affected by radiation here, and by God, look at that guy. He's like, I can't swim off! Still alive? No. Dog meat. Look at what's happening over there. You don't wanna see the funny person? He's doing things over there. That's fine by me. Alright. So, I'd really rather not use a stim pack. I'm just that, I don't know, that stingy on using them. Is there anything over here? Anything I need to know about? Somebody beneath me. Hmm. Interesting.